Hello everyone, in this video, we will learn on how to find a specific term of a binomial expansion. So as our previous lesson, you already learned on how to expand two types of equation. First one, we use the formula of a plus b to the power of n. We use this one whenever we have a integer, positive integer as our n. And another one is we have to use 1 plus ax to the power of n. So we will use this formula whenever we have a fraction or negative integer as our n. So next formula, we will learn on how to use tr plus 1. So for this type of formula, we will only use this one whenever the question asks you to find a specific term or a specific coefficient. Means you don't have to expand the equation. So the formula is tr plus 1 equal to ncr a to the power of n minus r b to the power of r. N is the power of the expansion. A is the first term and b is the second term. Okay, let's do an example. So for this question, we have to find the sixth term in the expansion of 2 plus 3x to the power of 10. Okay, so for this question, we don't have to expand. The question didn't ask you to expand up till sixth term. You only have to find the sixth term. So that's why we know we have to use the tr plus 1 formula. Okay, in order to avoid careless mistake, first step, you need to mention what the value for a, b and n. So directly compare here, our a in this case will be 2, b is 3x, and our power in this case is 10. Now directly compute each of the terms into the formula. So our formula is tr plus 1 equal to, now we have 10cr, and then we have 2 to the power of 10 minus r, and then we have 3x to the power of r. Be careful for 3x, make sure you put it inside a bracket or else you don't have exact power for each term. Okay, now we only have to compare this formula with the requirement of the question. So since the question asks us to find the sixth term, means t6, and based on the formula we have tr plus 1, directly compare this, our r plus 1 in this case would be 6, so r would be 5. And then moving on, you only have to substitute r as 5 into our formula. So we have t of 5 plus 1 equal to 10c5, 2 to the power of 10 minus 5, 3x to the power of 5. Okay, carefully substitute each of the value into your calculator. So now we have t6, the sixth term. So 10c5 would be 252. Next one, 2 to the power of 5, that would be 32. And for last term, carefully input each term. So we have 3 to the power of 5, 243. And then x also to the power of 5. And finally, our sixth term would be 1959552 of x to the power of 5. And that's how we find a specific term of the expansion without exactly expand the whole equation. Okay, let's do another example. So now we have to find the term that has x cubed in the expansion. So this is another variety of the question. They didn't mention about what term or which term you have to find, but the term that you need to find must have x cubed as the coefficient. Okay, we still have to use the same step. First, identify your a. So a in this case is 3x. And then b would be 5 over 2x. And then last one, our n or the power is 5. So carefully substitute each of these into the formula. So our formula is tr plus 1. And then we have 5cr. 3x, put it inside a bracket, to the power of 5 minus r. And then we have 5 over 2x to the power of r. Okay. So Next, that we have to compare our x with x cubed. But here, we have x at two separate parts. So, we have to simplify our formula first. So, I just split up everything. Means we split up the number and the variable. So, we would have 3 to the power of 5 minus r. And then x also would have the same power. And then we have 5 over 2 to the power of r. And then last one, x would be to the power of negative r. And then we combine our x variable, because next step we have to compare this with x cubed. So our tr plus 1 finally would be 5cr, 3 to the power of 5 minus r, 5 over 2 to the power of r. And then we have x to the power of 5 minus 2r. So now we compare x cubed with x of to the power of 5 minus 2r. So we have 5 minus 2r equal to 3. 2r is 2. So our r in this case would be 1. Next step, substitute r as 1 into our equation. So we have t of 1 plus 1 equal to 5c1. 3 to the power of 5 minus 1, 5 over 2 to the power of 1, and then last one, x would be to the power of 5 minus 2. So compute each of the number into your calculator. Finally, you're going to get t2, that is the second term, means the term that has x cubed as the coefficient would be the second term. And then our value in this case would be 2025 over 2 x cubed. Means the term that has x cubed in this coefficient would be 2025 over 2. So this is another example. Means you don't have to find, you don't have to expand each of the term to find the value for x cubed. You only have to find the specific term. Okay, let's do last example. Okay, so you have to find the term that is independent of x. Okay, in the expansion. So what does it mean by independent of x? Our coefficient or our term has no x. Term tu tak ada x at all. So kalau dia tak ada x at all, means our x would be to the power of 0. Okay, so as long as you find the term independent of x, means our x would be to the power of 0. Okay, so using the same step as before, identify a. So a in this case would be 2x cubed. And then b would be, careful with your sign. So in this case, it would be negative of 1 over x. And then our n would be 12. Okay, and then now substitute this into the formula. So we have tr plus 1 equal to 12cr, 2x to the power of 12 minus r, 2x cubed. And then we have negative 1 over x to the power of r. Okay, and then same as before, we have to compare this with x to the power of 0. But since we have x at two different places, so you have to simplify our formula first. Okay, so I split up between the number and the x variable. So in this case, we would have 2 to the power of 12 minus r, and then x to the power of 36 minus 3r, negative 1 to the power of r, and then last one, x would be to the power of negative r. So simplify for x, and then we would have this thing, and then x would be to the power of 36 minus 4r. So compare your x variable with x to the power of 0. In this case, you get your R as 9. Okay, And then substitute R as 9 into the formula, we have T of 9 plus 1 equal to 12C9. 2 to the power of 12 minus 9, negative 1 to the power of 9. And then last one, X would be to the power of 36 minus 4 times 9. And then compute each of the term into the calculator. Finally, our term that is independent of X would be the 10 term. And your variable or your coefficient would be negative 1760. Okay, so that is how you find a specific term or specific coefficient based on the TR plus 1 formula.